Alright, what up guys? Jared Campisi here. Wanted to bring you guys a cool video here today, how to run a 400. This is one of my favorite events in track and field, and because it brings in every aspect of sprinting. You have to have speed, you have to have endurance, and you have to have guts. And so I want to explain how I used to run the race, and just kind of a general race plan to give you guys an idea of how you're supposed to run the race, okay? So first things first, 400 is one lap around the track. Hopefully you know that if you're a 400 runner. If you don't, you might have other issues. But the first thing you need to understand is it's a sprint, okay? So the first 50 meters of the race, and what I do with my athletes is when we put cones out, the first 50 meters of the race, it's about 5 to 7 seconds. You're using a different energy source, so it's not gonna affect what you do in that first 5 to 7 seconds. In theory, won't have an effect on what you do in the last 100 meters of your race, okay? So what my coach used to call it and what I kind of refer to it as is free energy. So when you come out in that first 50 meters, just dominate it, okay? What I used to try to do is make up the stagger on the other person, you know? So if you're running and you're in lane 7 and someone's in lane 8, the first 50 meters, I just tried to make up the stagger immediately, okay? And if you're coming up on someone in the first 50 meters, they're in deep shit at that point. So that's the first, that's number one, okay? You're messing up my videos. We'll edit that out. No, it's okay. So first 50 meters, free energy, okay? Then after that first 50 meters, what I like to do is kind of take inventory of where I'm at. So if I feel like I'm in a good position or I'm feeling really good, then I'll just try to hold that pace, except just without pushing, without effort, okay? So the first 50 meters, you might be really grinding it out, you know, and you're generating all your speed. And then the next 50 or so meters, when you're coming off that turn, you're setting up your float phase, okay? That's what we like to call it. So when you're on that back stretch, after you've come over your first 100, and even heading into that back stretch, that's where I kind of take inventory, okay? Like I said earlier, I'm starting to see where I am in the race at this point, okay? Did I make up the stagger on the other guy? Did he pull away a little bit from me? Is someone coming up on my inside, okay? Hopefully none of those things are happening, okay? Hopefully you're running up on people, because we're setting up our float phase at this point. So whenever we come off that turn, took some inventory, you see where you're at, then we're coming into our float phase. And basically what that is, this is the hardest part for people to understand. It's instead of running your 100%, it's like your 95%, where you're still almost going just as fast, except there's no pushing involved. There's no effort, you know? It's just nice and relaxed and floating. And honestly, it took me a lot of warming up, to actually be able to even hit my float phase. Like, I used to just go on the infield before my 400s and just run strider after strider, back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, until my legs just felt so loose that it just took no effort. And that's the kind of warm up it takes to actually be able to get into a proper floating phase, okay? So that's the first 100 into your float phase. And your floating phase should be, at this point, you're not losing ground on anyone, and hopefully you don't need to make up any ground on anyone. That's where you're basically conserving your energy and you're setting up your turn. Now, this is where the race can turn into a couple different things. If you're an advanced 400 runner, I like to say push into that turn, because that's where you can start to break people. People get tired, people don't, you know, they know the pain's coming on the home stretch, they don't want to deal with it. So that's where you can make a move. So into that turn, I like to hammer that turn personally. And what that does is it makes moves on other people, it freaks people out, and it gives you the confidence that, you know, when the pain comes, you just run through it, okay? So you push into that turn over there, and then basically I just push through the whole turn, and then coming off the straight stretch, that's when you start to go to your form, okay? Because this is when you're gonna start to break down. You're in oxygen depth, you know, lactic acid's building up in your muscles. You're starting to come off that turn and come down a straight stretch, and it feels like you're running like this and you're like 4 foot tall and stuff. In reality, that's not what you look like, okay? But that's when I like to get nice and tall, go to my arms, nice and big arms, and I start turning over with my stride, okay? Instead of trying to reach out, like take big strides, big focus strides, that's when I go and start turning over, okay? And it's that kind of stuff that can save you at the end of your race. At that point, honestly, you don't see many people getting past there. If you've saved so much energy that you have a huge kick on the home stretch, you're running the race wrong, okay? If you're running the race just to win, that's one thing. But if you're trying to run for a PR, that's not how you're gonna do it. Me personally, and this gets into a lot of other aspects of the 400, depending on whether or not you're a 100, 200 guy running a 400, or if you're a 400, 800 guy running a 400. I was a 400 hurdler, so I had a good amount of speed, but I also had some endurance as well. So for me personally, to run a PR in the 400, I had to almost run as hard as I could the whole time. So, you know, but also employing those techniques that I mentioned earlier. So, yeah, and like I said, one of the reasons it's one of my favorite events is because you can beat guys that are faster than you. You can beat guys that are in better shape than you just by running smart and being as efficient as possible during your race. And on that home stretch, just having the heart and the grit and wanting it more than the other person. And that's why this race is so freaking awesome. And that's why it's one of my favorite events in track and field. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you learned something. If you have questions, leave them in the comments below. If it was helpful, like and subscribe. Catch you guys soon. And my life's gonna be just some string of incomplete.